urge the government to yield to the unconditional release of Mr. Aliche Martins, who happens to be a civil defense officer who joined the protest peacefully yesterday. He has since been arrested and yet to be released. We equally call for the release of cameras and phones that were seized from journalists at the protest ground yesterday. We demand for democratic measures in ending the insurgency and killings all over the country. We are equally asking, Mr. President, having sworn on oath to obey the constitution of this country, protecting the rights of all citizens, including that of Sowore and Mandate, who simply asked for better governance, to call on the DSS to obey the court of the land and release Omoyele Sowore and Mandate Olawale, as well as all other political prisoners immediately.
The DSS is only an arm under his government, and he's the one that should be held accountable and responsible for everything that goes wrong under his watch. It's just like the same way that we hold the leadership of the National Assembly responsible for whatever goes wrong in the National Assembly. That is how we hold President Muhammadu Buhari accountable for all ills that are perpetrated by his government. He's the one that is telling the DSS not to allow Sowore and Mandate to be released.
The judiciary has been annexed. The National Assembly has been captured. Labour Union has been suppressed. NBA is not talking. Even the CSOs have been divided. One thing I want to say is this. We are gradually, if not totally, in a fascist state. The Ninth National Assembly is an enabler of fascism. The Ninth National Assembly has failed the people of Federal Republic of Nigeria. Instead of fighting for the rights of Nigerians, they are siding with tyranny to oppress and to gag us. The judiciary is no longer the last hope of the common man. The social media is the last hope of the common man.